Good morning, Cars Cougars. My name is Mr. Suarez, so hoping you're having a great Friday. Today is Friday, February 25th, 2022. We have a few things coming up this week. Before we get started, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Dear staff, please fill out the Flipgrid for Stanley Davis's family, found in the link for Cougar TV show, which is daily sent by Ms. O'Connor. Again, staff, please fill out the Flipgrid for Stanley Davis family, found in the link for Cougar TV show. Thank you.
Cougar Country, here is some family news. Congress Middle School would like to welcome the following new Cougar staff: James Moulton, media clerk, and Ashley Campbell, paraprofessional. And we also like to congratulate Miss Indy on her promotion to head custodians at Carver Middle School. Her last day was January 28, 2022. Congratulations to all. Congress Middle School's Black History Program and a tribute to Stanley Davis will air live during Period 5 and Period 6 on February 28, 2022. That's next Monday. Faculty and staff are asked to wear red, black, and white. Again, faculty and staff are asked to wear red, black, and white. Students will come dressed in the same colors, abiding by school dress code.
Highlights from the teacher and student game that happened yesterday. We'll go over it during Monday morning, or during the Black History portion. I'm just giving a heads up whenever I get that information from the teachers. As administration getting ready for next year, so is my class and also Mr. Mayer's class. We're introducing drones for next school year. We have two options. We have underwater drones and also flying drones. Today, you get a chance to look at the underwater drone that I made last Friday, and hope you get a chance that you all can have to join the class and make yourself and we can compete with other schools. Here you go. So last Friday was at FAU High in Jupiter, and here are some teachers who are going to build some robots with me, and we're making ROV It's a cool campus. Now, what is an ROV? So what is Sea Perch? Take a look.
I'm Becky Stacey. I'm a technology teacher at McKeel Academy of Technology. And so we decided to build Sea Perch ROVs, remote operated vehicles. They came as a kit, and it was basically some uncut PVC pipe with electronic components just in plastic bags, circuit board, motors, and things, and the students had to completely put them together, including soldering the components onto the circuit board, waterproofing the motors, mounting the thrusters, and all of that. So it was a great project for the spring, and then we culminated by coming to the pool to test them.
We added weights because the buoyancy of the noodles made it go up too far, so we had to add weights to counteract the noodles so that it could stay buoyant and go down. It took us about a week or so to get all of it together because there was a lot of intricate parts, such as drilling holes in the right spots and attaching the motors with wax and water sealing everything.
This program was actually started by the Office of Naval Research. It's called Sea Perch, and the idea was to get students familiarized with an underwater drone assembly. So this one is actually a national competition, and here at McKeel, we're just starting out for the first year experimenting with it.
We had the privilege of being at FAU High up in Jupiter. Take a look.
Be part of a community where you can find your voice. Forge friendships. And discover opinions. Where you have the freedom to make your own path. This is Florida Atlantic University High School. Your future awaits.
Hi, my name is Caitlin. I'm currently a senior here. I am currently majoring in behavioral neuroscience. I am working on getting a lab that deals with connecting fear and long-term memory and how that affects the amygdala. I transferred here from Boca High 2 years ago, so I've had both experiences of working at a public high school and being here, and I think that this is a welcoming environment, and you can fit a lot of those students.
Then you've got your motors. We encase those motors in the old 35-millimeter film casters. The kids have no idea what that is, and that's kind of fun, a little fun conversation. Robotics Club at FAU, and there's not a student that leaves that program without a job.
This is my manual that I'll be using to make my Sea Perch robot.
So there will be teachers going to D.C., the D.C. area, serving over the summer, developing even more curriculum, and then they serve for a year.
Since this is my first time soldering, I'm paying close attention to the actual video. Imagine middle schoolers and high schoolers doing this here at Congress. Here are the helping hands to help you with the soldering techniques. And these techniques are also being taught at Boynton High School. So let's just give it ahead. And we'll use this to solder the circuit to the circuit board. Here's my box. Let me get started with help, of course. Here are the other school teachers who are putting together their underwater ROV robots. I think mine will be better. Now this is how my robot ROV should look like once it's done. Here's some one completed by other teachers. Of course, mine's the big one, which is not there yet. You'll see in the next few seconds. And now this is my ROV. It's going around. It's that one, the big one. It's little V. It's going. To try and get it to go underwater. Here's some other ones. It's not going underwater. I had to cut some more foam. It's getting tracked by other people. Don't worry. It'll survive. Now, let's do it. Now, the boys have named our robot Jibby. And look at Jibby dive underwater and 7 feet of water.
Stay there. Stay with it.
It works. If you want to do something like this, please talk to Mr. Dominguez, our engineering teacher, and he'll be happy to work with you in a small team to create your own robot. for our school here.
So our Black History Schools Padlet, and our Padlet, I'll show you the Padlet right after you take a look at some of them. The notes left by your students.
We gon' run with it now. Never look back. We done gone hundreds of miles from dark roads, heroes, to become a hero. Facing the League of Justice, his power was the people. Enemy is lethal. A king became regal. Saw the face of Jim Crow under a bald ego. The biggest weapon is to stay peaceful. We sing. Our music is the cuts that we bleed through. Somewhere in the dream we had an epiphany. Now we right the wrongs in history.
The Padlet website is http://l.sdpbc.net/wfm6x. That is the URL for the Padlet. And we want you to take a look at what your classmates are doing in regards to Black history and about self-identity when it comes to helping individuals deal with race and situations like that.
Your competitions will start this week. Please be on the lookout for this year's rubric from Mr. Haynes.
Staff and kids, have an awesome Friday. Take care and stay safe over the weekend.